Hello viewers, is your car overheating or running at temperatures higher than usual? Or maybe it takes ages for the heating to kick in during cold winter days? Well, in both cases, this could be down to a broken thermostat. As the name may suggest, these parts regulate the engine's temperature and keep it within certain limits. And most of the time, they will work flawlessly and won't cause any problems. But when they do fail, you'll have some sort of an engine issue. And in this video, we'll learn how to spot a malfunctioning thermostat and, more importantly, what to do if that's the case. Before going through the symptoms, let's quickly explain what the thermostat is and what it does. When running, the engine generates a lot of heat, which must be taken away. And assuming it's liquid cooled, this is done by a coolant pump and radiator. But to operate efficiently, the engine has to run at certain temperatures, which for most modern cars range from 195 to 220 degrees Fahrenheit. And that's where the thermostat comes into play, which controls the engine's temperature by regulating the coolant flow. When the engine is cold, its thermostat is fully closed, which prevents the coolant from going towards the radiator. But as it warms up, the thermostat gradually opens up. When this happens, the coolant starts flowing through the radiator and gets cooled down while doing so. From a mechanical point of view, the thermostat is effectively a valve that opens up at a preset temperature. For decades, its operation was controlled with a wax element, which expands or contracts depending on how hot is the coolant around it. Many newer cars, though, have a so-called map-controlled thermostat, whose operation is controlled by the ECM. In addition to the mechanical function of the wax element, these electrically assisted devices incorporate an electric heater, giving them an ability to open or close at different temperatures. As a result, cars with map-controlled thermostats can warm up faster and adjust their running temperatures depending on driving conditions. With the theory solved, let's now see what symptoms you might expect when the thermostat does fail. A faulty thermostat may cause a variety of symptoms depending on how it failed. First, let's see what could happen if it's stuck closed or doesn't open properly. As you may imagine, if the thermostat doesn't open, the coolant won't flow towards the radiator and back. And as a result, the engine will overheat within several minutes. This might, and in many cases will, cause extensive damage. For example, if you end up with a blown head gasket, you're looking at massive repair bills. Next, if the thermostat doesn't open fully, for any reason, the coolant flow will be reduced. This effectively means the engine will not be cooled down sufficiently, which might cause it to run hot. You're likely to notice this when driving on the highway or steep uphills. The consequences of a stuck open thermostat, though less dramatic, shouldn't be ignored either. For a start, the cooling system will run at its max if the thermostat is fully open. As a result, it will take much longer for the car to warm up, especially during cold days. From a driver's perspective, you might notice the temp gauge sits much lower than usual. And during winter, the air coming into the cabin through the vents might not be that warm. The reason for this is the cabin heater, which uses hot coolant for this job. Next, an engine that's not up to its running temperature will be running rich, which increases fuel consumption. This will be most noticeable if your daily driving involves a lot of short trips, during which the car doesn't warm up. And then you have the catalytic converter, which won't do well if the engine runs cold and rich. If your car has a downstream oxygen sensor, it will detect this and trigger a check engine light. The code you're most likely to see is the P0420, which could falsely lead you into thinking the catalytic converter is not good. Besides these two extreme situations, you might have other symptoms as the thermostat goes bad. With a thermostat going bad, you could see the engine temperature erratically going up and down. And this will usually happen if it opens or closes when it shouldn't. Apart from the temperature gauge acting up, you might notice fluctuations in how well the car interior is warmed up. And lastly, if the thermostat in your car is controlled by the ECM, issues with it might trigger a check engine light. And as always, this means there will be a code stored in the diagnostic memory, which you can retrieve with an OBD2 scanner. As with most components, the actual thermostat location depends on the vehicle in hand. But in reality, it will be in one of two possible and likely places. And that's where one of the radiator hoses connect to the engine. And in most cars, the thermostat is in a plastic or metal housing near the water pump, so that's where you should look first. Sometimes, however, the thermostat may be fitted in some awkward spot, which makes finding and replacing it more difficult. The thermostat is, in essence, a simple part, meaning there isn't a lot to go wrong with it. In most cases, corrosion and other buildups would form on its moving parts, preventing them from opening and closing correctly. This usually happens in cars whose cooling systems are filled with tap water and can be prevented by using proper antifreeze and distilled water instead. In addition, with an ECM-controlled thermostat, you might have a wiring issue or the heater inside it might burn out. Determining whether the thermostat is working correctly or not is sometimes difficult, but luckily there is an easy way of checking its operation which doesn't require any special tools or skills. First, you'll have to have the car fully cooled down, meaning it'll have to be turned off for several hours. Then, locate the radiator cap and carefully remove it. However, and I can't stress this enough, don't ever do this when the engine is hot, as the coolant might erupt and burn you. Also, keep in mind that in some cars, some coolant might escape when you take the cap off. With the cap removed, turn on the engine and check what's happening inside the radiator. If the thermostat is good, it should be closed at this point and the coolant shouldn't be flowing through. Otherwise, you have a thermostat that's stuck open. Now, leave the engine on for some time until it reaches its running temperature. At this point, the thermostat should open and let the coolant through the radiator. But be careful while sticking your head around the radiator to avoid being accidentally sprayed by hot coolant. If you don't see any coolant moving inside, the thermostat is most likely stuck closed. Alternatively, if you have a laser thermometer, you may use it to measure the temperature of coolant hoses. Again, wait until the car cools down completely and then start the engine. Then use the thermometer to check the temperature of both coolant hoses every minute or so as the car is warming up. If the thermostat is working correctly, at least one of them should be completely cold until the engine reaches its running temperature. This is when the thermostat should open and you'll see a coolant hose warming up very fast. First, here are some good news. Thermostats, especially mechanical ones, aren't very expensive. In most cases, you can buy them for less than 50 bucks. An ECM-controlled thermostat, due to its added complexity, could cost a bit more, but even as such, you're not likely to pay more than $100 for it. But as said before, getting to the thermostat in some cars can be a real challenge. For instance, if you have a car with a V6 or V8 engine, it could be buried deep within the V, with the intake manifold and other components blocking the way. So, if paying someone to replace the thermostat, you could face several hundred dollars in labor costs. Okay, that should be enough about thermostats for today, as we've probably got everything covered. And I hope you can now tell if the thermostat in your car is working correctly and what to do if it isn't. If so, give us a big thumbs up on this video and subscribe to our channel. On the other hand, issues with the engine's running temperature can be caused by other things like a clogged radiator or blown head gasket. If suspecting that might be the case, check out other videos here or visit our site mechanicbase.com for more detailed automotive repair guides. Bye!